ladies and gentlemen, once again, welcome to the Palace of Auburn Hills. At this time, get ready to welcome one of the baddest bad boys of them all. He wears number 10 from Southeast Oklahoma State. You know him as The Worm, a.k.a. Dennis the Rebounding Menace. Ladies and gentlemen, Dennis Rodman! Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, Michigan Sports Hall of Fame and the greatest broadcaster in the NBA, George Blaha.
Thank you, KC. Ladies and gentlemen, here at the Palace and Pistons fans everywhere, it's very exciting for me to be part of our ceremony honoring one of the greatest and most popular Pistons of all time, Dennis Rodman. Worm, as he was known to generations of fans of the Bad Boys, literally rewrote the book on rebounding and defense during his days in Piston Blue. A remarkable rebounder and a multi-dimensional defender. Let me tell you, folks, he guarded them all, the long, the short, and the tall, and he shut them all down. Dennis, this is the highest honor our franchise can bestow upon you, and you are very, very deserving. It's going to be wonderful in a few moments to see your number join those of your world championship Bad Boy teammates, the team put together so wonderfully by General Manager Jack McCloskey and coached masterfully by our friend, the late, great Chuck Daily. That's for you, Chuck. Let's meet our honored guests for this momentous occasion. First, Dennis's family, his wife Michelle, son Dennis Jr., daughter Trinity, and daughter Tiana Bobby Moyer Troy. His special guests, Steve Simon, Darren Prince, Thayer Mustafa, Keith Benson, George T., and from the Giannopoulos family, John's son Peter, and brother Pete Giannopoulos. Now let's meet some of Dennis's Piston family, representing the Davidson family of the late Hall of Fame owner, Mr. Bill Davidson, Mr. Davidson's wife, Karen, and son, Ethan Davidson, the architect of the 89-90 World Champs, GM Jack McCloskey, one of the Pistons' all-time great shooters, Bad Boy champion John Long. We know him as Buddha, sweet shooting big man James Edwards, one of the baddest and toughest big men to ever play the game, Rockin' Rick Mahorn. He was true to his nickname because he heated up in a hurry, the Microwave Vinnie Johnson. A media star these days and a star shot blocker and rim rattler for the Bad Boys, John Spider Sally. He was a star guard on two championship teams. He built another Motor City title team from the front office, part of the Bad Boys Hall of Fame backcourt, Piston president of basketball, Joe Dumars. He willed the Pistons to the mountaintop with his all-world blend of brains, toughness, and talent. One of the greatest to ever play the game, our number 11, Isaiah Thomas. Our first speaker drafted Dennis and brought him to Detroit. His name hangs from the rafters, deservedly so. The Bad Boys general manager, Jack McCloskey.
The Palace, the Palace, the Palace. Boy, we got a lot of memories here, don't we? And Dennis, this is a special night for you. And I'll remember the first time I saw you play. You were in Portsmouth in a tournament. And then he won the most valuable player in that tournament. But now he goes to Hawaii. Didn't play real well. He goes then to Chicago. No, this is a tournament, a college tournament in Chicago. And he could not play well at all. And Mike Abdenauer, who's a trainer here, and I always said, Mike, we're going in. You go into the locker room and find out if there's anything wrong with these players. He came back and said, he shouldn't have played at all. He's got allergies, and we got to fix him. And I said, Mike, can we do that? Yes. That's why he's here. Okay. The draft comes up. Mr. Sally, Dennis Rodman is there. We've got the 15th pick and the second pick in the first pick in the second round. And I said, I gotta be greedy. I gotta try to get both of them. Drafted John and desperately waited for that first pick in the second round, and there he was. The two of them, and they made and they helped. Thing. Dennis, I played in the old Eastern League before the NBA. So I have seen every player since the NBA existed. You are the greatest defender, the most talented rebounder that I have ever seen.
Wow. Thank you, Jack. Our next speaker's number 15 hangs from the rafters here. He did for the Pistons offense what Dennis did for the defense. Vinny Johnson.
Thank you. Dennis, welcome home. It's been a long time. We miss you, buddy. I tell you, this franchise is unbelievable. I remember when I was traded here in 1981, when we started rebuilding this franchise, we added a piece every year, you know? We got Rick in, got Buddha in, but when we really got Dennis and John Sally, sorry, Sally, especially Dennis, that's when we really started to make our move. Dennis, you're the ultimate teammate. You sacrificed more than any other Piston that I ever played with. You gave up offense, even though he can play offense. But he gave it up because we got a lot of guys who like to shoot the basketball. Right, Zeke and Joe? He did all the heavy lifting. He played the toughest guy on defense every night, and he played him for 48 minutes. Got every rebound. Even rebounds we didn't think it was possible to get. Kept the ball alive. Without this man, we wouldn't have won two championships. Dennis, I thank you for that. I know Detroit thanks you for that.
Thank you, Vinny. Our next speaker came to the Pistons in time for the 86-87 season, and with the Worm, he transformed an excellent team into an all-time great team. John Spider Sally.
Dennis, I'm a little bit different than Jack and Vinny. I'm finding the camera. Oh, there's the camera. I got to say this. Dennis and I were together when Jack was talking about we was in Hawaii, and Dennis had a bad asthma attack in the cold and never been around that many people or women. And so I took advantage of it for him. But literally the guy just surpassed everything and every expectation and became the greatest rebounder, defender, and one of the best teammates I've ever been around and one of my greatest friends. I love you. You deserve this.
Thank you, Sal. Sal. What our next speaker did to make the Pistons champs was remarkable. One of the most beloved athletes ever in the Motor City, the one and only Isaiah Thomas.
Thank you. I would just like to keep mine really short and sweet. We wanted to be champions here. We wanted to deliver you championships. But most important of all, we wanted to start a tradition. And all of you are part of the tradition, your fathers, your sons, your mothers, your daughters. Thanks for sharing in this tradition with us. Dennis, you've been a lot of places, but there's no place like home. You won championships in Chicago. You played with some of the greatest players to ever play. You came close in San Antonio, playing with some of the greatest players to ever play. In every place that you've gone, the team has gotten better, and you've won. And again, the next step that you take in your basketball career, you will always be a Piston. We love you, Worm.
Thank you, Isaiah. And now the man of the hour, who poured so much passion into his play as a Piston. This is your night, Dennis. Let's hear it now for the man who gave all the blood, sweat, and tears to this franchise, the Worm, Dennis Rodman.
Since I got that out the way, you know what? This is a great honor. As I said before, and I say it again, and these guys here were like my big brothers. My big brother. I was a young kid when I came here, right? And Yeah. Sorry, man. Sorry, guys. But anyway, these are like my big brothers. Jack McCluskey took a chance on a young man, and that was me. And I came here, as he said, I had the flu. I had asthma attacks and stuff like that. He took a chance on me. He took John Stallett in front of me. I don't know why, but for some reason, my career turned out to be pretty good. Sorry, John. Sorry, John. But anyway, you know, me and John came into the Pistons. and I just like to thank Jack McCluskey for just taking a chance on a young kid from Oklahoma. Thanks, man. Thanks, Jack. John Long, Buddha, Rick Mahorn, Vinnie Johnson, John Sally, Joe Dumars, Isaiah Thomas, and all these guys here, guys, you don't understand. If you look right here at all these guys that are sitting right here, it's not too many organizations can produce and bring good quality people out. And these guys here have great, great livelihoods, great jobs, great opportunity. Joe Dumas, Isaac, all these guys here do one thing, is represent the city of Detroit always. I'm getting through it, guys. I'm getting through it. But you know what, guys? What I said in the papers, and I hope you guys don't take this as offensive. No, it's not about the Chicago Bulls. Forget that right now. It's not about that. Not about that. It's not about that. What I'm going to say is that I've always said, you know, this is about a team game. It's about the people here in Detroit, the hardworking people here. And I said in the paper, I said, I don't think I deserve this. I keep saying it. I just say it because I should have been here a little longer to deserve this honor. And, you know, it's like, you know, it wasn't my fault. It wasn't my fault. But you guys deserve a little bit more. And I'm just trying to do one thing, trying to get through this speech right now. Bear with me, okay? So, anyway, I just want you guys to recognize this is my family right here. You know, people don't know, do I have a family? So here they are right here. So people don't know that. Right here. So my good friends back there, those guys right there. So I have a lot of other people here. And I'd like to thank Mike Abdenauer. He's been here for 35 years, man. Mike Abdenauer. 35 years, man. 35 long years. And all the guys at the score tables here has been so, so gracious to everybody here, man, for so long, man. And it's amazing, you know what? I know you guys don't understand that Karen, you know, Davidson, sorry. Oh. But I want to do something before I end this whole thing here. And I hope you guys let me do this. And those two guys right there, and I think these guys can share their emotion with me. So anyway, just to thank the Davidsons, thank you guys for doing one thing, taking care of me, taking care of this whole franchise here. Without for like this, I'm gonna be biased. Without these guys here, without me, Bill Laimbeer, and all other guys, these guys over here wanna have anything to be proud of right there. Right here, this right here has been a foundation for you guys to succeed after us. And I hope you guys win more championships, brother. More championships, man. But anyway, thank you, Peggy. Thank you, Elkin. Thank you, Nancy. Thank you, Frank from Ocean Manor. Thank everybody that's came here out tonight. Have a good time, baby. You know what? Let's have a good time.
The Worm, Dennis Rodman. Now it's time to raise your famous number 10 to the rafters, Worm. As you join the all-time Piston greats, buddy, let's walk over here and get this done. This is where you belong. Among the Piston immortals. It's your family and your teammates and your friends. Number 10 is going up. That's a beautiful shot right there. Dennis Rodman and family, as number 10 is raised to the rafters. Let's hear it one more time for Dennis Rodman. He joins the all-time Piston greats. Next stop, Worm, the Hall of Fame. Thanks, everybody.